Hey everyone, so today I'm coming at you with a really quick tip, and that's how to control two computers with one keyboard and mouse. So I've moved recently and I'm just getting my setup back together. It's why there's been a lack of videos. And in the process of getting my setup back together, I actually got a gaming computer in the form of a HP OMEN gaming desktop. So now I have two computers in addition to my MacBook Pro laptop that I need to operate off of this one gorgeous 4K LG 27 UK850 monitor. One of the coolest things about this monitor is that it can charge and output video from one USB-C cable to the MacBook, and it runs the HP OMEN gaming desktop off of the display port. Now, if you're looking for a free solution, it is possible, but it will require two computer monitors, or in this case, it could be this monitor and then having the laptop open and not underneath desk like I have now. The free software is called ShareMouse, and that allows you to control two computers using the keyboard and mouse you already own using this free software. However, this is actually quite a small room, so I need a really minimal setup. This is actually quite a minimal desk. And with that, I want to keep my laptop in clamshell mode under this little monitor stand. So I actually wanted to find a more hardware solution that could solve this problem for me. And I actually found it with the Logitech Craft Wireless Keyboard and also the Logitech MX Master 2S mouse. This is not a sponsored video. These are certainly high-end devices, however. I did manage to nab them while they were on sale on Amazon. The keyboard for £109 or €123, and the mouse for £61 and €69. However, they're similarly priced to Apple's equivalent Magic Keyboard and mouse, and they come with more features like backlighting, a dial app for specific functions, or to globally change the volume and brightness settings. I also appreciate that it has universal key bindings for both Mac and Windows functions. If that's a little pricey, Logitech also creates a budget combo called the Logitech MK850, which currently retails for about £75 or €85, and it does the exact same thing. You lose the backlighting and extra tricks, but you get a really solid combo set, and even this budget combo has a layout that shows both Mac and PC key bindings. I personally didn't test the keyboard, but it does share similar switches and design to this wired keyboard, which in itself is really solid. But then again, my standards are so low because I was using a butterfly keyboard as my main keyboard for the past few months. All of the hardware I mentioned comes with a unifying receiver. So if one of your computers doesn't have Bluetooth, for example, like a gaming desktop, you can plug it into that and enable it to connect to the keyboard and mouse. It's really simple to set up. I assigned the first option for the MacBook laptop, which is my main computer, and I assigned the second position to the gaming desktop. The third position is currently vacant, but that just shows how versatile these keyboard and mouses are. The last question you might have is, how convenient is it over a software solution like ShareMouse? And I have to say, for this scenario, it is pretty convenient. And that's because there's a rhythm to how I change computers. And that's because I'm using one monitor. So when I want to switch from Mac into the Windows desktop, I have to change the monitor input anyway. So I know after I change the monitor input to also change the position on both the keyboard and the mouse. So for those also in the process of making their setup more optimal and you have two or more computers, I hope you found this video really helpful. Subscribe to see more videos like this right now, and I want you to leave a comment if you actually are going to use this solution. Are you going to use the ShareMouse free tool? Are you going to invest in maybe a hardware solution like I've shown? Or have you found a better way to do what I'm trying to accomplish? Because if you found a better, more convenient way, I want to know. So if you have, leave a comment below as well, like the video, and thanks for watching. Side note, this is actually less convenient than you think. Like, it's really convenient, but plugging USB ports into it is tough. Like, it shouldn't be tough, but it is, just because the ports are all the way at the back. I'm even considering obviously just flipping the laptop, which I'll probably do right now. Duh. And people say you don't get an aha moment on camera.